Welcome to Physics 292, an introduction to climate physics. Any course on climate physics will have to start with the sun, since all of our energy that determines the climate on Earth is provided by the sun. And then we look at our beautiful planet. Here I'm drawing the outline of the lands, and our planet is blanketed with a very thin atmosphere. The atmosphere provides the air that we breathe, and it modulates the surface temperature of the Earth such that it is habitable for us humans. It's called the blue planet because most of its surface area is covered by the oceans. However, from us, maybe more importantly, is the climate on the land surfaces, since that's where we mostly live. Another integral feature for the Earth's climate are the ice-covered poles. In the northern hemisphere, this is predominantly sea ice, and in the southern hemisphere, the Antarctic continent is covered with a thick layer of land ice. This is of particular interest to me, since my research is concerned with the role of ice in the climate system. Once we have introduced the main components to the climate system, we'll talk about energy fluxes. The first one here is the solar radiation that is emitted by the sun and absorbed by the atmosphere and by the land and ocean surfaces. Then we'll talk about how the atmosphere reacts to changes in energy, predominantly through winds and heating and cooling. Next, we'll look at the dynamics of the ocean circulation driven by the winds or driven by thermohaline differences. And we'll talk about how the Earth emits energy, loses energy, because if it was only ever absorbing energy from the sun, it would keep heating up further and further. So there's terrestrial radiation that produces an approximate balance between what energy comes in and what goes out. There are many more components to the climate system that we may or may not touch on. For example, clouds or the role of biomass. And hopefully by the end of this class, you will have an understanding of how all of these components work together to determine what we call climate, how scientists study it, how it has been changing and will change in the future, and the challenges and opportunities that such change will bring for us.